Now that our stereo system is fully calibrated, the next step is to find correspondences between points in the left image and the right image. Ideally speaking, for every point in the left image, you want to find the corresponding point in the right image so that at the end of the day, you end up with a dense depth map of the three-dimensional scene. So let's take a look at how we find these correspondences. Let's start with what we did in the case of simple stereo. If you remember, in simple stereo, you have a left camera and a right camera. The relationship between the two is very simple. It's a very special configuration where the right camera is essentially the left camera translated along the horizontal direction by some distance b, which is the baseline. In this very special case, where both the optical axes are parallel to one another, for any point in the left image, the corresponding point in the right image we showed must lie on the same horizontal scan line, which is shown right here. In other words, stereo matching reduces to a 1D search. It turns out that in the case of uncalibrated stereo as well, once we have found rotation and translation between the two cameras, the stereo matching problem still remains a 1D search. But the question is, along which line in the right image should we be searching? So that brings us back to epipolar geometry and the notion of the epipolar line. So here you have your epipolar plane. We know what the epipolar plane is. It is unique for any given point P. It includes the point P and the epipoles, and it also includes the centers of the two cameras right here. So that's your epipolar plane. The epipolar plane intersects with your two image planes to produce these two lines here, red lines. And these two red lines are referred to as the epipolar lines in the left and right images. So every scene point has two corresponding epipolar lines, one in each of the two images. So how do we use this? Well, so now if you're given a point in one of the two images, let's say the left image, UL right here, it turns out that the corresponding point in the right image must lie on the epipolar line in the right image corresponding to that particular point, P. So this makes sense because if you consider UL, UL corresponds to a single outgoing ray right here, this ray. And the projection of all the points on this ray onto the right image is really what the epipolar line corresponds to. So for any point here, all you need to do is to search along a single line in the right image to find the matching point. Now the question is, which line do we search along? Well, it turns out that given that we know the fundamental matrix, for every point that is given in the left image, we can derive the equation of the straight line in the right image along which the search needs to be done. So finding correspondence once again reduces to a 1D search. So let's see how we find epipolar lines. Let's assume that we are given our fundamental matrix, we have calibrated our system, and we're given a single point in the left image, UL, VL. What we want to do is to find the epipolar line in the right image. So we're back to our epipolar constraint, which is this right here. In this particular case, we know UL and we know F, and we want to find an expression for UR. So if you write this out, you get this expression right here. And you can simplify that to get this straight line equation right here. So given that we know the fundamental matrix, you give me any point in the left image, which is ULVL, I can tell you the line in the right image along which the corresponding point should lie. That's the straight line right here. Very simple. So similarly, if you gave me a point in the right image, then I can give you the equation using the same method for the epipolar line in the left image along which you need to search to find the corresponding point for the point in the right image. All right, so here's an example. So let's say that this is your fundamental matrix, which was computed for these two images right here. And let's say I give you one point in the left image. These are its homogeneous coordinates. These are the pixel values, homogeneous coordinates. So simply plug that into your epipolar constraint and you get this equation, straight line equation for UR, VR, and that corresponds to this line right here. So what that means is that now if you want to find the matching point for this point in the left image, in the right image, you would take a little window around it and apply template matching along this red line and find the point where you get the best match. So that is finding correspondences, and that brings us to the last step in our stereo process. We have found dense correspondence, and now what we need to do is to find these corresponding pairs, use them to triangulate and compute the depths or the coordinates, three-dimensional coordinates of points in the scene.